Hey guys, welcome back to another video. Today is we are doing a top 10 Blink 182 songs. I know I did this one a couple years back, but now Blink 182 has finally returned with Tom DeLonge, and they have come back to release their new album that comes out on Friday. This Friday of recording of this video, I cannot wait. October 20th. I've been so pumped up. Every song they've been dropping has been amazing so far. I'm so excited. One of my favorite bands of all time. Here we go, number 10, baby. On it, let's make this may last forever and ever. Let's make this last forever. And number 10, yes, is First Date. I love this song so much. I love seeing it live. Really boosted it up to the top 10. Originally it wasn't, but seeing it live was so cool because they played it toward the end of their set and everything, and it was awesome. It was so cool because they were like saying like, this night will last forever and ever and ever. And it's like, oh, it's kind of cool because, you know, it's like at the end of the song, it was a smart idea to play that near the end of the song. Beautiful song. Love it. Let's go. And number 9 here is, yes, Edging. I love this song too. When they dropped it back last year in October, I knew Blink was back. I was like, oh my god, this song sounds like classic Blink. We're getting, Blink is finally here, finally back. Also, you guys see this one live on their tour. It was absolutely amazing. This song is so fun, so awesome. One of the best comeback songs that I've ever heard in my entire life. And I'm still listening to it to this day. And number 8 is I Really Wish I Hated You. Now, people may attack me for this, but I love 9. 9 is one of my favorite Blink albums. When they dropped it with Matt Skiba, that's what kind of sparked my, getting back into Blink. Like, I kind of fell away from them for a bit, and then they dropped 9, and I'm like, oh my god, this album is actually amazing. But this song right here, I Really Wish I Hated You, is such a sad, heartbroken song. 9 might be, besides self-titled, this might be one of their most saddest albums of all time. It's so good, beautiful. I love this song too. It's so good, amazing. Love it. And that's about the time she walked away from me. Nobody likes you when you're 23. And I saw more abuse by TV shows. What the hell is ADD? My friends say I should act my age. What's my age again? Number 7 is What's My Age Again, a classic Blink 182 song. One of my personal favorites. I grew up with this song. I'm empty like the day after Christmas, swept beneath the wave of your goodbye. Number 6 though is Boxing Day, and when I never really listened to Dogs Eating Dogs for a while until like I got back into Blink later on, and I listened to this song. And it hits me so hard. Every time I listen to this song, it like wants to like beat my heart out and put it on the floor and like try to grab it and put it back in. And Tom and Mark's vocals coming on the acoustic vibes here really hits hard. And number 5, heading into the top 5, is another song from 9. This is No Heart to Speak Of, the best song off 9, personally. Matt Skiba's vocals really roar off on this song. And it's so immaculate. Love it so much. And it's just so depressing, so sad, very relatable. Hits hard from home. Love it. Banger. Matt Skiba, again, his vocals. Probably his best vocal work on his song, too. I don't wanna act like there's tomorrow. I don't wanna wait to do this one more time. One more time. And number 4 though is one of their newest songs for this album. It's One More Time. When I first listened to this song, I felt like a hole was in my chest. I did a reaction video to this too a couple weeks ago last month when it came out. So you can go check that out too. But oh my god, this song literally makes every single Blink 182 fan literally in tears. It's so good. Just the lyrics, the verses hit so hard from home. Plus the chorus goes in there and they get Travis Barker saying, "I miss you," and "One More Time." It's so good. Oh my God. It's like everything that you wanted from a Blink fan, as a Blink fan, from Blink. And it's amazing, immaculate, heartbreaking. And number three, though, is Aliens Exist. Now, I love this song so much. It's a weird one to put in my top three. Yes, it is. But hear me out. I love this song because not only is MSDA one of my favorite albums of all time, I used to have this song. I used to have the Paper Jams. And this song was one of the songs on Paper Jam, was Aliens Exist. It's just Tom DeLonge talking about aliens. You can't get better than that. And number two, though, is my favorite song from Enema State, and obviously one of my favorite Blink songs of all time, Adam's Song. And oh my God, this tear-jerking, retching song, a cult classic, Blink 182 literally made a masterpiece from this song. Beautiful, I love it. Oh. But at number one is Stay Together for the Kids. Oh, this song, ever since I heard it for the first time, has always been my favorite song. I'm like, this is my favorite song. My favorite song. It's so heartbreaking, so fucking good. I love this song. It hits so hard from home. Like, it's like if like a friggin' Babe Ruth hit a home run, hit a grand slam home run. That's what it feels like whenever I listen to this song. It's so amazing. Tom's vocals on the chorus hit so hard. The instrumental goes so hard. Mark's vocals on the chorus, lyrically masterpiece. Everything about this song just shows that Blink-182 are immaculate. They're one of the best bands of all time. Thanks for watching this video, guys. Those were my top 10 Blink-182 songs. Comment what your favorite Blink-182 song in the comments below if you want to. Blink-182's One More Time album comes out this Friday, and I'm gonna decide I might do a reaction video to it. Let's go.